Hello everyone, welcome to Social Club. The running begins from now for the teams who were, shit at cup football. There's 10 games left to play in the Premier League. For those who are a bit better, there's a couple more. So we thought we'd start to look at what might be happening between now and then. More importantly, for teams in and around the top six, top seven, which are the teams that are going to miss out on that fourth spot and the glory of Champions League qualification. I'm joined by Flav, I'm joined by Chris, and I'm joined by Jean-Paul Gaultier as well.
Or whatever you decide to say in the comments. I expect where's Wally.
Let's get stuck into it then. We've got the fixtures, the remaining fixtures of the teams who are going to be involved in this in front of us. Some of us have got highlighted sheets, some of us have not.
Instead of ones that did well at school.
Lad.
Yeah. So we thought we'd have a look at who we think's got the most difficult run and therefore how we think that's going to impact things. You know, we start off, Chris, you and I were discussing this on Red Men this morning about how Liverpool right now have got the points on the board. They're in the top four. They've done what they can do, bearing in mind the catastrophic January and whatever that they had. So Liverpool have got, there's something to be said for having those points on because, you know, ultimately, as you said yourself to me, this Premier League season's been a bit mad. You would rather have the points on the board than have the games.
Yeah, right now, I think, you know, you look at Arsenal, they've lost three of the last four games. We're 5 points ahead of them with two games in hand. We're 6 points ahead of Manchester United. I know they've not lost in a long time and stuff, but they've had plenty of draws in the last 10 games. And yeah, just for everything that you've just said, Liverpool have got the points on the board, and I think now we can start to focus on the teams ahead of us a little bit. You know, the Harry Kane injury, you know, we're all waiting with bated breath to find out how long he's out for, because Tottenham's season could derail. I'm not saying it will do. Jansen obviously gets a goal from open play the other day.
This is nothing to do with Tottenham. Let's just move on.
Right, you're only a point ahead of us though, aren't you? And look, this season's mental, and I think out of all the top seven, I genuinely believe Liverpool have got the best fixtures, because I've broken it down and we've got two of the teams who are in the top seven to face, and we've got three of the teams in the bottom six or seven as well. And I think, you know, when you get towards the end of the season, I start to worry about those teams low down, because I feel they've got something to fight for.
Sure.
You know, I'd rather be playing games between seven and like 12 in the league, they're just dead rubber games, it don't matter to them. And we've got more of those teams to play than anybody else, and that's why I like Liverpool's running.
Okay, brilliant. James, what about you? Who stands out? If you're looking at the fixtures, who do you think's got the most, the trickiest runner, who might be in a spot of bother come May?
I think Man United have actually, despite being unbeaten for as long as they have got a really quite tough running, really. Just because, as you say, at this part of the season, the teams down the bottom start winning, teams at the top start getting a bit nervous. You want to be playing West Brom, you want to be playing Stoke, you want to be playing those middle guys, because they're on the beach.
It's a great point, James.
It's a fantastic point, if only someone had thought
of it. All right.
But Manchester United are four of the top seven and four of the bottom seven.
Yeah.
So he's totally right at what he's saying.
That last four games for Man United, Swansea, Arsenal, Spurs and Palace.
Yeah.
Unless Swansea keep winning like they have been, and are fine, that's four huge games for everyone involved, and I think that's why it's slightly misleading, the fact that you look at their form, the form guard of Man United, it's really, really strong, unbeaten in ages. But like you said, I think you're right, Chris. I think having the points on the board is a bigger deal.
I think, and I'm sure you'll probably be delighted to agree with me, I think Arsenal are in, this is the most likely, we've been saying this for 20 years, more over the last 10, you know, this will be the season when Arsenal finally slip out of the top four. They've been a shoo-in for so many years, they've been so consistent, but I don't think you can underestimate the destabilising impact of fans protesting during matches. They're due to fly a plane over the ground at the weekend. You know, Liverpool have been in that situation. It does, they can't but affect the players on the pitch. They're not in great form, there's loads of issues. This could be a bad season.
Yeah, I think even Wenger said about, you know, the fans' opinion is going to help him decide whether or not he's going to be the manager of Arsenal next season. So it is in their heads, and you know, whether you like Arsenal fan TV or not, it's having an influence in the upper echelons of the club, and that has to have an effect. I think Arsenal are in a situation they haven't been in before, because like you say, there is this this horrible atmosphere around the club at the moment. They've always rebounded after a bad period when they seem to find a unity out of nowhere and go on a run and end up finishing above Tottenham and securing their place in the top four. And I wouldn't bet against them doing it again because history would suggest, but there is no point in history if they've gone through this, or certainly in Wenger's reign in the last 20 odd years. So I hope with all my heart, obviously as a Spurs fan, I think all of us hope that Arsenal finish in the top six. At sixth, because you remember at the start of the season when we did our predictor and we said, where did they, we say they finish? Sixth. If they mirror the exact same results against the teams remaining as they got previously in the beginning of the season, then they finish sixth currently.
Finish sixth, really? Which would be absolutely mental.
Are you nervous with Liverpool and the way that you've been able to do well against the good teams and not so well against the others? Your final eight fixtures are Bournemouth, Stoke, West Brom, Palace, Watford, Southampton, West Ham and Borough.
So we briefly went through this a while ago, and I would say the ones that frighten me most out of those, it's probably maybe Crystal Palace, Southampton, who've completely
scored against them three this season.
They've just got us figured out this year. It's ridiculous. I suppose they've had enough. They've got enough sleeper agents, haven't they? They've sort of integrated into our ranks over the years. No, I'll be honest, James. I am. I'm nervous because, this is how football is, I guess, isn't it? That when if we talked about top four 3 months ago, I was like, it's not even a consideration. Liverpool will finish top four, and it's about whether we can maintain a title challenge. Now, the title challenge completely evaporated in January, and what happened was because everyone else around us kicked on and kept winning games, and we kind of faltered around that point. We've made it difficult for ourselves. As you say, if everyone wins their game, if people could cleanly win the games in hand, they would. You know, we would not be in the top four. I'm pretty sure. The good thing that we've got going for us is that it's the teams that play each other around that, and if we can get through, we've got Man City followed by the Merseyside derby. I think if we can get through those games in good shape, we can take, God, you know, obviously absolutely ideal if you can take 6 points from that. You know, you then go in with such confidence into that back end of the season, and I think it's the pressure that starts to tell on the teams around, because I don't think any team apart from Chelsea, let's not even worry about Chelsea, I don't think anyone's going to go unbeaten between now and the end of the season. The hope is that we're just able to scrape together enough points while everyone else slits each other's throats.
And that leaves, sorry Jim, that leaves 8 games. If you win those 2 games, that means you've got 8 games left, and the games are disappearing. And you're talking about massive swings now. Like Man United are on a 6 behind you. That's a 12-point swing. They need to gain, and you need to lose a total of 12 points.
Potentially, yeah.
The thing with Man United.
Sorry, Paul. I don't buy into this. Generally speaking, I don't buy into this. Look, you need to be worried about the Stokes. We've snotted Stoke once this season. We've snotted Watford once this season. We've battered Borough. You know, there's a few games where we've lost 5 games this season or whatever, and we've been terrible in those games. But generally speaking, everyone's now piling on that Liverpool can't beat teams in the bottom of the league. We can. We've done it consistently this season. We've won more games against teams below us than we've won.
Yeah.
Those outliers
aren't the ones.
Yeah, but it's not true. People just take it as it's like fake news, isn't it? Oh, Liverpool can't beat them. Well, we just did it at the weekend.
We
beat Stoke 4-1. We beat Watford 5-1. Or you know, we can do it, and we've proven that we can do it well.
And I think where it's gone wrong and where that sort of idea has come to be is because you're in the middle of the season and you're probably looking at those bigger games, two games down the line. You know these are the last 10 now and every game is massive. So Liverpool aren't going to underestimate any of those guys. And Stoke, West Brom, Watford should all be absolutely fine by that time, mathematically. So I think you should do
I think the big thing that's going to tell in this, because we've actually not got it because it's not been scheduled yet, Man United play Man City. That's one of the games in hand. It's not been put back into the fixtures. I've been literally refreshing my football app on my phone every weekend to see if that's coming at any point, because that's massive. You know, there's potentially three points that one of those teams is simply not going to win that weekend. And you know, I look at Man City and I'm still astounded they're not home and dry, you know what I mean? Or it's not them and Chelsea in their own little mini league battle at the top end of the season, because I look at the quality they've got there and the manager, etc., etc. I look at their run of games, and they've now got Liverpool, Arsenal, and Chelsea back to back, with Man United still to come at some point between now and the end of the season. And you know, they're massive games, the massive energy draining games as well. They're still going to have eyes on the Champions League. So the teams, so many of these teams have still got FA Cup football to think about as well. And again, that's where that Liverpool's anyways hope comes, is that, look, we'd all rather have won the League Cup and we'd all rather still be in the FA Cup and we'd rather be in Europe. Of course we could. But those are still the things that Liverpool should have going for them, is that we're not worrying about this weekend. We know when our next game is. We know what players we're going to have available for it. We can scout those teams and we should be able to play them better. Whereas there's other going concerns for these other teams.
On top of these fixtures, what they got left in the league? 11 games left in the league. Yeah. Mm-hmm. If they get to the final of the Champions League, that's another 6 or 5. If they get to into the FA Cup final, they could potentially play still another 20 games this season. I mean, that's going to affect their league form.
It'll tail off. It has to tail off. They have to make at some point, they've got to make a decision, don't they, about what competition's more important to them.
Well, there's so many of these teams.
We know Man City rate the Champions League above all.
But they've won the league.
Exactly, yeah. But this is the thing that so many of these teams are going to have to face. There's going to come a point, and it's going to happen. It's going to start happening soon, where all of these teams, if they are to have good runs in cup competitions, they will have 2 games a week pretty much for the rest of the season. If they get, you know what I mean, the particular ones who are right at the top end of things. And we all know it is very, no matter how good your squad, and it is very difficult to manage midweek to weekend. You know, as much as we go, the highly paid professionals, fuck that. You know what I mean? It's a thing for a reason, whether we agree with it or not. Yeah. It is a thing. And there comes a point where you do have to prioritise, even if it's only in a fraction. And I think that's what something that might face Manchester City in particular will have to face that. And look, even Manchester United, you know, if they get through against Rostov, all of a sudden they'll probably draw. You finally draw a decent team normally when you get to the round of 16 in the Europa League, and that's when you go, ooh, we've got to start taking this seriously. And the players mentally start to think that's the most important thing for me, because Man United keep winning and you have to keep staying sixth. At some point, their players go, fuck this, all we ever do is toil away in the league. Forget it, I'd rather make sure I'm absolutely on it this coming thing.
And Ibrahimovic, 2 games going to be missing as well, isn't it?
So they win their 2 games now, and then they're kind of in and around the same points as you lot, but I think worse goal difference. But it made me laugh then. I laughed at myself because the Europa League is what a bitch of a competition.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
The last 16 now, still got 4 rounds to go.
There's been 79 fixtures Man United have played this season in the Europa League already. There's still another 80 and a 2-man sack race after the finals, to make sure it's done.
And they don't rotate, do they? And you're seeing that's where they've got a few injuries at the moment. You know,
they went as full strength as they could, I think, pretty much last week, apart from the goalkeeper.
Yeah.
They're taking that seriously. As to he will do. You know, it wouldn't shock me to see Man United kind of give up on the league, and you know, given how well they're performing in cups, and we'll know a bit more later in the week. And later, by this time next week, we'll have a clear indication of where Man United season's heading. Mm. But I don't think Jamie Carragher, I think it was, laying down the gauntlet over the cup treble. And saying, look, you know, could you do what Liverpool did in 2001 or whatever? Wouldn't shock me to see Man United go, we can win individual games. Maybe we'll make a focus on that one.
Something to think about. If Man City win the Champions League and Man United win the Europa League, then the fourth place doesn't qualify.
Sure?
Yeah.
100%.
Yeah.
Where'd you get that from?
The internet. Dun, dun, dun.
Oh. They wouldn't lie to you.
I'm not sure of that.
No, I don't think that's true either, to be honest with you. I think the winner of the competition automatically gets it. Last time, because we were talking about it last season, weren't we, Paul?
Yeah. I don't know why would they win in the Champions League? I don't see why that's the only difference. I'd not considered that in the past, but I don't see why them, if as long as it's someone who's qualified. Well, sorry, are you sure? If you finish outside the top 4 and win the Champions League, that might be the only situation I can imagine that would be the case.
Well, maybe the internet's wrong.
Yeah. If you do more in-depth research than Flav on this, and you know more than me,
feels right.
Feels right. It does. Not well. Depends on the circumstances, doesn't it? Let us know that in the comments if you know that to be true or not.
Can Everton get
source it as well?
I was gonna say about Everton. I don't know if they can get top 4.
What?
But at this point, I'm glad that it's our derby, because I think, you know, them with us is a little bit different. But Everton are going to have a huge say in the top 4 race, because they've got Arsenal, they've got, who else, they've got Chelsea, Bush, Manchester United. You know, so they've got some big games, and I think that I fancy them to turn a few teams over, because they're in great form as well.
They can't finish in the top 4 though.
Listen, we're talking. No, no, I don't think so. I think Everton will put a good run together. That club needs a bit of optimism, to be perfectly honest. Like, you know, and I think they, and I think they, I actually think they deserve it to some extent. They've been kind of browbeaten for so long over stuff. But I think I think Everton will end the season on a high, and I think they'll all go into the season buzzing. But I think Everton finishing the season on a high would be putting a real good challenge in for six, and if they come higher than that, then wow, incredible. But I think top four is a bit much of an ask. So look, we've talked around it, we've talked through the teams. Anyone want to throw some suggestions out then? Who's missing out?
Arsenal and Manchester United, yeah. And Everton.
Yeah.
Okay, James.
Yeah, I was going to say the same. To be honest, I think it'll be exactly the same as it is right now.
Okay. Oh, what a season that would be. Yeah. Lovely.
I don't think it's going to be. I think the top four is the same. I think the order. I'm still banking Liverpool second. I said it at the start of the season. I'm sticking with it. I think Manchester City might lose focus, and I think the Kane injury really defines your season.
Mm. Yeah, I think that'll be an interesting one to see. Yeah, I you'd be honest. I think it will be. It's lovely to sit here and go. Oh, it makes me feel loads nicer. I think that everyone have got Liverpool in the top four. It's not going to be that easy. There's going to be some heartbreak between now and then. There's going to be some real stress that happens. But it would be stupid of me. I'd be the worst football fan in the world if I didn't back Liverpool to get in the top four. And moreover, at the expense of someone like Man United.
Mate, you've got 10 games to play. That's it. That's all you've got to play this season. But as we've said, Man United may have 20. City may have 20. Arsenal... you know, they've got two games to catch up on you as well. Mm-hmm. So they've got to play 12 as opposed to your 10. You're in a good position.
I just think the thing with Arsenal is that if Arsenal were in another part of the league, and with all the destabilisation of the managerial thing and the protest and blah, 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 they would just cut another football club, would just basically fuck him off and get someone else in now just to give a lift for the end of the season. I don't know where that lift's coming from for Arsenal. They could only be... You know, a good win, a good couple of wins back to back could change everything. It always seems to do that, but I just don't feel as though that's going away any. And it does feel like it's a perfect storm of things not going right for Arsenal for a change. So it wouldn't surprise me to see them miss out. And the thing is, when you watch the video you guys did around the protest, and you got guys saying top four, like forget top four almost. It's more important that we sort this out. To me, anyway, that seems like a massively backwards mentality, and I really hope the players think it too.
And I think with Arsenal, there's this idea that every single year this happens, and that's where they're getting angry. But the thing that kind of always turns it around a little bit is they have this amazing run in. I think those last four games, Spurs, United, Stoke, Everton, last game of the season, mm-hmm. I think that's where they won't do well in those, and they will finish outside the top four. And then I think Wenger will go.
Fingers crossed. Okay, so brilliant. There you go. Who do you think are going to be the teams that miss out on Champions League football for next season? Let us know in the comments below. If you agree or disagree with any points made, feel free to send targeted abuse by the comments section. Give this video a thumbs up and check out for the rest of Social Club this week, where we're going to be looking at who's going to be getting relegated, because we know, absolutely know, and whether Spurs, are they fucked if Mr. Kane is injured for the rest of the season? Or just a week or two.